Welcome to part 6 of my vehicle tutorial. It's been a while since I worked on this project, so this is long overdue. In this part, we'll be looking at implementing a gear system for our car. Note that there are a bunch of things added to the project, such as background loading and a new test track. As these types of things have already been covered in other tutorials, I won't repeat them here. If you are interested, you can watch the recordings of my streams, as I have done a lot of this development while broadcasting live. You can catch my streams every Friday at 9 PM Sydney, Australia time. To implement our gear shift, we are going to create a feedback loop. We'll calculate how fast our engine should be turning for our current speed. We then determine what the maximum power output of the engine should be at that RPM. And then use our throttle input to calculate how much power we need to input into our vehicle body. This does mean our simulation currently only works if our car has traction. As before, we will expose key parameters as export variables so we can use the same script on loads of different cars. We're starting by copying some pre-made variables in here that contain all our gear ratios. These are the actual gear ratios from the CSR. We have the gear ratios for each gear, our reverse gear ratio, and our final gear ratio. We also need to have a variable that tells us our current gear selection. -1 will be reverse, 0 will be neutral, and 1 through 6 will be our gears. We'll come back to changing our gear selection later. For testing, we'll start in gear 1 for now. Next, we're going to add a function to our script that calculates the RPM our engine is turning at for our given speed. If we are in neutral, we'll just return 0. Let's also type our return value to float, that helps us out later on. Now we need to work our way back from the speed of our car. The first step is calculating our wheel rotation speed. For this, we need to know the circumference of our wheel, which is 2 times pi times our wheel radius. Our wheel rotation speed is simply our car speed divided by our circumference. We multiply by 60 because we want this speed in rotations per minute. Now we can calculate our drive shaft speed by applying our final drive ratio. If we are in reverse, we'll apply our reverse gear, but we don't want this to be negative. Else, we apply the correct ratio for our selected gear to get our engine's RPM. I'm being a little over careful here by double checking if our gear selection isn't out of bounds. Just for debugging purposes, let's show our calculated RPM on screen by adding it to our label. We'll also display which gear we've got selected. We need to fix a mistake here. It is size, not LEN, we need. Now that we know the RPM of our engine, we need to figure out the maximum power output we have at that engine speed. We are going to cheat here a little for now, because we're not simulating a clutch yet. We'll introduce a curve here that allows us to look up the power output, but as a curve will have an input from 0 to 1, we need to scale our RPM. For that, we need to know the maximum RPM. For this engine, that is 8000. Now we add a variable for our power curve. We can't set a default curve here in code, so we'll do that in the property editor. On our horizontal axis, we are going from 0 RPM to max RPM. On the vertical axis, we go from 0 power to max power. Now we'll add points to create a very basic power curve. Note that I am cheating a little bit and providing a small bit of power at 0 RPM to deal with our missing clutch. And we'll have a steep drop-off at the end to simulate our rev limiter. We can tweak the angles a little by adjusting these blue handles, but I'm not going to mess with it much. To implement this into our car's logic, we start by obtaining our RPM. We'll want that value as a value between 0 and 1, so we divide by our maximum RPM and clamp the value. Now we look up our power factor by checking our power curve. We'll quickly move our brake calculation down a bit. If we are in reverse, we calculate our engine force as our throttle input times our power factor times our reverse gear ratio times our final drive ratio times our maximum engine force. That is a mouthful. If we have a gear selected, we do the same calculation, but we use our correct gear ratio. And finally, if none of those are true, we cut our engine power altogether. We'll switch our reverse light based on our gear selection. When we test this, we can see that our acceleration is pretty slow when our engine isn't outputting a lot of power, and then suddenly it picks up and we hit our rev limiter pretty quickly. So, let's add the code we need to change gears. For this, I have added two input actions in our input map, one for shift up and one for shift down. To shift gears, we're going to create a function in which we're going to handle our inputs. And we'll call that from our process function. We use isActionJustPressed to check if the player just hit one of the gear buttons, so we don't shift if they just keep the button held down. When we shift down, we check if our current gear is above -1, and if so, we shift down. When we shift up, we check if our current gear is less than our highest gear, and if so, we shift up. We can now change our default gear back to 0. Now, when we test this, we can see that we can shift gears. I am having a lot of problems steering the car at higher speeds. We'll need to do something to make the steering more gentle when using a gamepad, but I'm going to come back to that in a separate video. Right now, when the player shifts gear, the gear shift is instantaneous. That is not very realistic. While I want to improve on this solution, once we start looking at different input devices, for now we're going to add a gear shift delay. We'll add a new variable for our clutch position. Next, we'll add a variable that specifies how long it will take to shift gears, and a variable that times our gear shift. In our process function, we are going to pass delta to our gear input function. If our gear timer is bigger than 0, that means we're shifting gears, and we'll decrease it by delta. Else, we'll check our gear shift. We set our gear timer to our shift time whenever we shift gears. Finally, we make sure that if we're shifting gears, our clutch value is 0. And when we're not changing gears, our clutch value is 1. Finally, we make sure that when our clutch is engaged, we don't put any power to our wheels by simply multiplying our power with our clutch value. Doing a final test, we see that the gear shift takes a fraction of a second to be applied. That is where we'll leave it today. Next episode, we're going to look at mapping our input to different devices, as I've bought a Logitech G29 setup, and I want to be able to switch between that and my gamepad. Then, we'll return to our gear shift logic and implement both an automatic gear shift mode and a full manual mode, including clutch pedal input. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like. See you next time!